What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today it's extremely hot in the office. Oh my God, it's hot. But today's video is all about restricting application access using AppLocker with a group policy. So let's get right into it. All right, so today's all about restricting access to particular applications on a Windows 10 or a Windows 11 machine using AppLocker. We're going to do it with a GPO. Later on, I'm going to show you guys how to do it using Microsoft Intune. So the first thing that I'm going to do is get into my workstation. And within my workstation, I'm going to open up the Active Directory User and Computer Management Console. The reason that we're here is because I created a security group and it is called BTNHD Denied App Access. Whoever's inside the security group will not get access to whatever application that we are going to define within the app locker. Now, within this group, I only have one user. That user is called Bruce Wayne. Yes, Bruce Wayne, Batman. We're going to lock him out. Also, within my test OU, I have PC01 because PC01 is the one that Bruce Wayne is going to log into and we're going to test out the new GPO. Now, we're going to open up the group policy management. Within here, I like to right-click on the group policy objects folder. We're going to select new. For the GPO name, I am going to give it the following. Pretty self-explanatory. It is going to hit the computer configuration node and app locker policy. Straight to the point. Let's click OK. Let's select our new GPO. Let's right-click on it. Let's select Edit. Now, before I start editing, a couple of things that I have learned the hard way dealing with AppLocker. When I was testing out AppLocker within my infrastructure, I was trying to block Notepad. Notepad is basically notepad.exe, which is located within the systems32 folder on the C drive. When I blocked that, it caused so many problems. A lot of things were not working properly when I was trying to block that particular EXE. I feel like AppLocker trying to block Windows 10 or Windows 11 applications like Notepad, and I've only tested out with Notepad, maybe Command Prompt, PowerShell, stuff like that will cause a lot of problems. If you want to block, let's say, Command Prompt, PowerShell, Notepad, etc., there is a particular group policy that you are able to configure, and I'm going to show you guys later on with another video. You're able to block it using the processes name of that application. So within our new GPO, we're going to head into the computer configuration node. We're going to open up the policies folder. We're going to head into the Windows settings folder. We're going to go into the security settings section. We're going to go into the application control policies, and we're going to select AppLocker. Now, on the right-hand side, we're going to locate and click on Configure Rule Enforcements. Now, in this section, I'm going to enable everything, and I'm going to set the following. Executable rules, I'm going to enforce the rules, and everything else, I'm going to set it to audit only. We're going to click Apply. We're going to click OK. Now we're going to open up AppLocker and it's going to give us our four sections, executable, Windows installer, script rules, and package app rules. We're going to select executable rules. We're going to right click on it and we're going to select create default rules. All right, this is the groundwork. So the way that AppLocker works is whatever you deny, hits first, and whatever you have allow hits second. Okay. So the allow basically allows all the programs to work properly within the user's computer. But if you have something denied, it hits first, and then the allow goes second. We're going to head into the Windows installer rule. We're going to right click on it. We're going to select create default rules. We're going to go into the scripts rule. We're going to right click on it. We're going to select create default rules. We're going to select package app rules. We're going to right click on it. We're going to select create default rules. Now, the reason that I created all the default rules, because again, I learned the hard way when I was configuring only the executable rules, a lot of stuff was not working properly. And I feel like it was maybe because I was denying Notepad. But once I set all these four AppLocker sections to create the default rules, stuff started working properly. But it did not work when I was trying to deny Notepad.exe. When I denied another program, it actually worked. So we're actually going to head into the executable rules because this is what we are going to work on. But before that, I'm going to use PC01, which is the machine that I showed you earlier. This is it right here. We're going to click on start, and it is already logged in as Bruce Wayne. We're going to open up the File Explorer, and the particular exe file that I want to deny Bruce Wayne to have access is this one, which is located within the root of C drive. It is CM trace. So let's head back into our group policy. We're going to right click on the executable rules, and we're going to select create new rule. You're going to get the wizard. We're going to click next here. Again, user or groups. I created a group, so I'm going to click on select. I'm going to type in my group. I'm going to click OK. And for the action, we're going to set it to deny. Okay, make sure you set it to deny and click next here. You have three options, publisher, path, or file hash. I am going to do a path. I'm going to click next. And the path will be the location where the exe file is located. So I added the following. Once you do that, click on next. For exceptions, I left it as is. So I click next here. Provide a name, I left it as the default, and I clicked on create. Now, for AppLocker to work properly, you need to have a particular service up and running automatically to identify what application AppLocker is denying. So we're going to head into the system services folder of this group policy. On the right-hand side, we are going to locate application identity. We're going to double-click on it. We're going to check off define this policy settings, and the startup mode is going to be set to automatic. We're going to click apply. We're going to click OK. We're going to close our new GPO. Now it is time for us to apply our GPO. So I'm going to select my test OU. I'm going to right click on it. I'm going to select link an existing GPO, and we're going to select our new GPO, and we're going to click OK. And that's it. Now, don't go anywhere. There's going to be a quick demo of me logging into PC01 as Bruce Wayne. At the very beginning of the demo, I'm actually, you know, launching Notepad and the settings app because I was making sure that the app locker policy did not, you know, cause problems to those particular applications. And then once I confirmed that stuff, I think I went to the settings and I show you guys that I am within PC01. And then I go inside the C drive, I double click on CM trace, and then bam, access denied, it's blocked. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Again, stay tuned for the demo, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.